Good day to all of you, and in this video, I will be discussing teaching and learning in the time of COVID-19 pandemic, and with a specific focus on flexible learning. So let's take a look at, So we all know, and we are, I think many of us have experienced this, that during the early part of the year, this year, 2020, schools were closed because of the COVID-19 pandemic. And this is just to make sure that we are protecting our students, we are protecting ourselves as teachers, and as well as the other staff or employees of the universities. So because of that, because of this closing of schools, many academic institutions resorted to emergency remote learning. So what exactly is this emergency remote learning? The Commonwealth of Learning defined emergency remote learning as an attempt. It is an emergency measure, as the term implies, to replicate the classroom teaching and learning process, and it is in an online mode of instruction. Because it happened so quickly, it was so sudden, there was no time for us to prepare, many of our teachers were described as instructional MacGyvers. And I think for many of you, especially those within my generation, we are familiar with MacGyver, a person, an individual who had to make do with whatever resources, skills, knowledge that he has in his possession so he can address the problem that he has at the moment. We can say that because of COVID-19 pandemic, many academic institutions, many teachers were forced to embrace online learning. And given the situation of the internet connectivity in the country, what happened was instead of forcing teachers, academic institutions to go online, the announcement was for us to consider from the basic education, technical vocational institution, higher education, for us to consider the flexible learning mode of education. So what exactly is this learning mode of instruction? So we can look at flexibility. Flexibility in instruction as a function of technology integration. So the higher the level of technology integration, then the higher is the level of flexibility in the kind of teaching learning process that we are considering. So face-to-face, we can consider face-to-face as the least flexible, given that both teachers and students are required to be present in a physical classroom so that teaching and learning can happen. We are also familiar with the blended mode of instruction, which is a combination of the face-to-face classroom instruction as well as online. And distance education, which is the kind of instruction that we have to implement now under with the COVID-19 pandemic, then we can look at distance education offline, distance e-learning, which is a purely online, and distance education with the blending of online and offline modes of instruction. So let's take a look. What exactly do we mean by this concept? So, of course, we are familiar with the face-to-face instruction, and this is the learning environment, as I had mentioned, wherein students and teachers are required to be both physically present in the classroom on a scheduled time, day, for instance, so MWF, 8 to 9, so to speak. So we have to be there for us to be part of the teaching and learning environment. When we talk of blended learning, still in the context of classroom instruction, then we are talking here of the strategic and systematic approach to combining the time and modes of learning. So there are learning sessions which happen in the classroom, and there are also learning sessions that happen online. And this is where the flexibility lies, because the student, the learner, can decide at what point, what time, and where will he or she engage in the teaching learning process if it is already in the online mode. But when we talk of blended learning in the context of distance education, then we can also look at the different modalities of doing online learning. So we also blend the mode of instruction in online. So we can now talk of synchronous, wherein both the teacher and the learners are present at a specific time, at a specific schedule, but in a situation which is technology mediated, which is what we call the synchronous online session. And of course, the asynchronous or different time, different place for both the teachers and the students, asynchronous online session wherein a learning management system or a virtual learning environment will have to be used as the place or as the platform for the teaching and learning activities or events. Distance education, again, this is something that we are doing now. This is a mode of instructional delivery wherein the teacher and the learners are separated in time and space. And we are using here especially designed materials and methods, and we are using different appropriate technologies like the learning management system, the Zoom platform, for instance, and whatever platform you may so decide to use so that you can deliver instruction as well as facilitate the different learning activities. When we talk of e-learning, initially, we are in a general description or definition, we are referring to learning that is enabled electronically. But through the years, e-learning has become synonymous to online learning, which is being defined as a new method of education involving technologies that allow the student to complete a course outside the traditional classroom. So it is usually hinged on the internet. So when we talk of e-learning, we are already talking here of the use of internet. And when we talk of distance e-learning, it is that mode of instructional delivery wherein we are now combining that being distance, not physically present in a physical classroom, as well as the integration of the ICT, modern ICTs, to deliver quality education as well as learner support to the students. When we talk of the dimensions of flexibility, we also refer to this one aspect of flexibility is when and where learning occurs. So we look at what time are we requiring the students to participate? Are we giving them the flexibility to choose? Can I do it in the evening? Can I do it during weekend? Do I have the freedom to select, specify the time that I will be engaging with the different learning activities? So that's one dimension of flexibility, when and where the learning occurs, especially on the part of our students. Another dimension of flexibility is how to deliver instruction. Are we asking our students to access the learning materials in the classroom, in a web-based technology, or using other technologies such as augmented reality? So how are we doing the teaching, and how are our students accessing the learning material? What strategies are we using to organize the learning activities? Are we giving lectures, just like what we are doing in classroom instruction? Are we giving or allowing independent study, discussions? Are we allowing our students to do group work, collaborative work, or engaging in a discussion, for instance, just so that we can relay the lesson or the input to our students so that they will be able to perform the different learning activities as well as achieve the learning outcomes. Another dimension of flexibility is the type of learning resources that we are providing to our students. So what are these learning resources? In a classroom instruction, we always talk of lectures. That's the instructor-created content. Sometimes we also ask our students to do class reports, topic on lessons. We assign them to our students. Sometimes we ask them to go to the library. Sometimes we ask them to look at the internet for the resources that we feel they need to study, to engage in, for them to learn the lesson that we have included in our course. Of course, we can also consider Are we giving them a podcast? Are we giving them printed materials, books for instance, video materials for them to view, or synchronous lectures like in Zoom, or the ones that we are all familiar with now. Teachers are also now being advised to consider open educational resources for their teaching. And these are materials that can be accessed again through the internet, but without worrying so much on copyright issues, especially if we're going to use them as our learning resources. Another dimension of flexibility are the technologies which we will be using for our teaching and for our students to learn. These are not just technologies that are within our reach or that are available to us as teachers. We also need to consider if these technologies that we are planning to use in our teaching are also available, accessible, and affordable on the part of our students. So it's not just about the learning platform, but also the communication medium that we are going to use so that we can continuously, regularly communicate with our students. So we can consider email, even instant messages, or again, text messages as our form of communication with our students. The important thing here is that we will be able to maintain a regular communication with our students, technology-mediated communication process. The other dimension of flexibility is when and how to provide assessment, exams. But we have to note that it's not just exams, the test, standardized tests that we always do in classroom instruction, that we need or we can consider when we talk of learning assessment. E-portfolio is one method, and there are also platforms, free platforms that we can use if we want to consider e-portfolio as a method of assessment. Also, do we give flexibility to our students in terms of when and how will they be taking the assessment that we have designed for our courses? In online courses, one tool that we can consider in order for us to monitor the progress or assess the progress of our students, academic progress of our students, is learning analytics. And in most learning management system, learning analytics is a common feature. And this is a tool that we teachers can use for the monitoring of our students. When we talk of online learning, when we talk of flexible learning modality, we always talk of technology. And sometimes there is this apprehension among teachers that we will be replaced by technology. So this is a message that I want us teachers to always keep in mind. Technology will not replace great teachers, but technology in the hands of great teachers can be transformational. Also, for those who are saying or thinking that online learning or distance education is a second-class thing or even inferior to classroom instruction, then this is something that we also have to remember. Physical proximity isn't a precondition for good education. Comparing one form of education to another distracts us from the fact that all forms of education can and should be made better. And this is also another reminder. When we think of the mode of instruction, when we think of flexible learning mode, we should always keep in mind that there are others, other students, other sectors in the society who may not have access to the internet. And this scenario is something that we don't want to happen. So whatever mode of learning delivery that we will choose eventually for our course, for our, in our university, we just have to be always keep in mind. We always have to keep in mind that it's not just equity that we need to ensure, equity in access that we need to ensure. We also have to ensure that our students will have that equity in achieving the learning outcomes, and that we can do through the design of our courses. So I think that's all that I can share about flexible learning mode. So again, thank you very much for joining me in this video session. Thank you.